We often hear Palestinian supporters refer to the so-called West Bank and half of Jerusalem as occupied territories. They say Israel doesn't have a right to the land. But in one small Italian town, history tells a different story. Here's Chris Mitchell from San Remo, Italy.
Former Israeli President Chaim Weizmann said this picturesque town on the Mediterranean played a crucial role in Israel's modern history.
He said that it's not an exaggeration to say that the Jewish state was born in San Remo.
Following the defeat of the Ottoman Empire in World War I, leaders of the Allied powers met in San Remo. Their goal? A new Middle East. While most of the land went to the Arab people, the Jewish people received back their ancient homeland.
What happened here in San Remo in 1920 transformed the Middle East, and for the first time in nearly 2,000 years, the nations of the world recognized a Jewish homeland.
What is very important to understand is that, long before the Holocaust, there was already an agreement that the Jewish people had a right to statehood, they had a right to self-determination, just like any other people groups.
2014 marks the 94th anniversary of the San Remo resolution. Israel also recognizes San Remo as a present-day foundation in its battle for a place among the nations.
Since there is an effort today to question our legitimacy, we have to go back to San Remo and say, look, here is the international document agreed by all members of the League of Nations at the time, that says that, yes, we have this right.
And that right provides historical ammunition to fight the boycott, divestment, and sanctions movement called BDS. It aims to persuade companies and countries to withdraw money and investments from Israel.
It counters the arguments of the BDS movement to say that, you know, Israel is a colonial power. It is the opposite. Many historians would say that the San Remo resolution also was the beginning of the decolonization process, because here we have a people group that have been occupied for 1,800 years about, that are finally getting their recognition of statehood.
Sandel adds anyone questioning the modern state of Israel can find the answer in this Italian connection.
When we today have this whole question of, do the Jewish people really belong in Israel? Do they have a legitimate claim to the land? That question was decided once and for all in 1920 under international law here at this very place, San Remo.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, San Remo, Italy.